Hello, welcome to Holiday TV. I'm Vienna, and today, December 7th, we're here with Lindsay Rust, who is the artistic director and co-founder of Dancing Drum. Welcome.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about your job.
Okay, well, I drum with kids for a living, which is really great. So I get to go into schools and bring drums, and we play the drums with the kids, and it's myself and my husband, Steve. So we go in, we drum, we perform, and get the kids with their hands on the drums and experiencing how cool it is to make music together.
That's fun. Is that mostly in elementary schools?
Well, actually, elementary schools, we really do all ages. So we do preschool, elementary, junior high, high school, adults, senior citizens. And drumming is really one of those cool things that can work for all age groups.
That's really great.
Yeah.
So, do you involve your work with the holidays in any way? Holiday season?
Yeah, we do some different things. Like, for instance, this year we're working at one school where we're having an artist-in-residency program, and the whole program culminates in a performance just before all the kids take off for Christmas break. So all their families will come, and everybody gets to kind of get together as a community before they go their separate ways for the holidays.
That's
really
great. Yeah. And I see you brought your drum with you.
Yeah.
Great. What kind of drum is that?
Well, this drum is called a djembe, and it's an African drum from West Africa. And it's a drum that you play with your hands. Yeah.
Great. And you sell these drums on your website, too,
We do, actually. And we'll be selling them for the Christmas holiday as well, so we'll be having a special sale. If you go to our website, dancingdrum.com, you can check out all the different drums we have. We have different sizes. This one is an 11-inch drum, which means it has an 11-inch diameter head. And we have bigger ones and smaller ones, and some drums that you play with sticks that are called jujus. Various fun little shakery things and stuff like that.
Cool. So more about you. Can you tell us maybe one of your favorite childhood memories from the holiday season?
Sure, yeah.
Were you raised with Christmas or Hanukkah or Kwanzaa?
My family was Catholic and I was raised with Christmas. And I was actually raised in a small town in Indiana, so we would have a lot of white Christmases. We would always have a big, beautiful Christmas tree in the corner window where the busy street went by.
Oh, okay.
It was so beautiful, and the windows would get all frosty and the lights would look so beautiful. But my favorite part of Christmas was always turning up the Christmas music and trimming the tree.
Yeah.
So, you know, as soon as you turn on that Christmas music, it's time to go up to the attic and get the lights and the Christmas decorations and bring it all downstairs and start trimming the tree as a family. And it was always just a really nice, sweet way to start the holidays.
And as a child, were you interested in music?
Oh, yeah, I love the music. Christmas music, too. There's some real great classics. You know? Johnny Mathis, I'll Be Home for Christmas. Ella Fitzgerald, and Burl Ives. Gosh, there are all kinds of things. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. So much great Christmas music out there.
Great. Cool.
Yeah.
So, do you still celebrate the holidays, you know, now that you're in Santa Barbara? We don't have many white Christmases, but
yeah.
Are you still doing the same thing? Or?
Well, you know, I don't always make it home to Indiana for Christmas, unfortunately. I always like to go back there, but sometimes just because of the way things work out, and now that I'm married, we have two families that would like us to come home for Christmas. So, you know, I don't always get to go home, but here in Santa Barbara, my husband Steve and I, we always like to have a Christmas tree, and we turn on the Christmas music and do the same sort of thing, kind of on a smaller scale, because we live in a smaller place, but, you know, that's really an important part of the season for me, the music and the trimming of the trees, and just kind of doing that together as a family.
I know, it's about togetherness and family.
Yeah.
Great. Well, what's your favorite part about your job? And, you know, I know that you're with the kids all the time, and that must be really fun.
Mm-hmm. My favorite part is introducing the drums to the kids, because something about, you know, kids don't always believe that they can do drumming. They don't always believe that they can play together as a team. But once they get their hands on the drums and they learn how to make the different sounds on the drums, I think a lot of times you'll see they surprise themselves because they maybe at the beginning of class, maybe they thought they couldn't do it, they didn't know how to do it. But by the end of class, they're really proficient and they can play the drums and they sound good. And so you just really see a lot of smiling faces and people, kids who feel good about themselves.
So can you tell me maybe, I mean, there must be so many kinds of drums all over the world. Have you had the chance to see all of them and try all of them? Or?
Well, that's a very good question. I mean, I think I could spend my whole life traveling the world and not discover every kind of drum because there's so many different kinds of drums. In dancing drum, we like these djembes and djunjuns, which are the traditional West African style of drum. But we've also been really lucky to be able to travel to study different traditions of drumming. For instance, Thai drumming. We were in Thailand and we got to spend some time with the drummers there and learn their tradition, which is called Klong Yaw, which is a type of drum that's kind of shaped like a djembe, but about 2 feet longer. It's a very long drum. And we got a chance to go to Belize in Guatemala to study Garifuna style drumming, which is a whole different shape and style of drum. You know, you go to any country in the world, for instance, here in the United States of America, there's lots of different drumming traditions. For instance, Native Americans have a very alive drumming tradition. If you go to New Orleans, that's where the drum set was invented, the drum kit, the cymbals, and the kick, and the hi-hat, and the ride, and the snare drum. And, you know, in New Orleans, they were the first people to put all that together into one drum set or drum kit. If you go to India, they have different styles of drumming all throughout the country. India, North India has different styles. South India, China has its own style. Japan has its own style of drumming, Taiko drumming. In Mexico, they do their own thing. In South America, in the Andes, they have their own styles of drum. So it's really, like, endless. You could go travel around the world and study drumming for your whole life and never get bored.
Well, what a great,
I would love to do that.
What a great job that you have the chance to travel and do what you love. And, you know, you were saying earlier that rhythm is everywhere and everyone has rhythm, or I mean at least they can hear the rhythm, and, you know, that's great that everyone can pick up a drum and at least hit it and, you know, make a sound.
Yeah, absolutely. We say if you have a heartbeat, you can play the drums.
Exactly. That's great. Well, thank you very much for being with us, and all you that are watching, Lindsay Rust is here with us, and she's a great drummer, and she's part of the Dancing Drum group, and go on the website if you're interested in checking out some drums, and thank you.
Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days.